I know that you have been wasteful in software development. And today we are going to look at the 9 types of waste in software development. The first type of waste which we are going to look at is partial done work. Partial done work is the work that sits in the pipeline and is not yet done. This can be code that is not yet committed. It can also be tests that have not yet been executed. But it also refers to, for example, when we are doing something, developing a feature, and we suddenly need to stop the work on that feature and go to another feature. This is partially done work. The second type of waste is extra features, also known as gold plating. This is done when the PO thinks this nice to have feature should be done by software development, but it does not add any value to the customer and the customer does not need it. The third type of waste in software development is extra processes. Extra processes are process steps which do not add any customer value. And don't get me wrong, there are process steps that are needed, for example, through regulatory needs. Of course, they need to be done and they don't really, in the end effect, will add any customer value. But they keep you safe and therefore they are good. And we can also automate these. But what I am talking about are extra processes which are needed because someone needs, for example, a report and does not need this report or reads really this report. So these are extra processes which are useless and should be removed. Task switching is the fourth type of waste. Task switching is always then when we are doing something and we get interrupted by, for example, another colleague or by something else that we need to do, and we need to concentrate on the second thing and then go back to the previous task. And this task switching always costs us to load and reload all the information in our brain, and this causes waste because we need a lot of time to do that. The fifth type of waste in software development is handoffs. Handoffs are always when we are doing something and we need to give the information to someone else. So the information moves to someone else. There we usually have some loss of information during that process, and this is also something we should minimize or should automate. Defects or bugs are in our software. But the problem lies not with defects that we already have identified. It is also the defects that are lying hidden in our software. So we should always build in quality as much as possible and eliminate defects as fast as possible. The seventh type of waste that we have in software development is non-standard work or manual work. Of course, there are cases where manual work makes sense because the business case of automating it is negative. But we should always go into the direction that non-standardized works is eliminated and automated. If not possible, then we document the steps that are needed so that we can remember these steps when we do them the next time. Waiting or delays are also waste in software development and should be reduced. We need to constantly analyze our value chain so that we can eliminate these waiting times. An example for waiting time is waiting for the CI/CD pipeline. When we are waiting for the building, the integration, the unit tests, and also the deployment, and this goes too long, then we wait too long and we don't get fast feedback. And the last waste in software development is heroics. We always have that hero in our project, which can solve everything. But the problem with that is that you don't invest into automating the stuff that he fixes. And you don't invest in fixing the problem or the root cause of the problem. So always focus on automating and fixing the root cause of the problem is better than having these heroics. These are my 9 types of waste in software development that I have identified during my projects. What are your types of waste that you have identified in your project? Just leave me a comment in the comment section and leave me also a like if you liked that video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel because I produce every week a new video for you.